So here I'm in Sakai, and I'd like to just simply demonstrate how you can go through and add items to a created checklist so that they automatically check off. Now, there are some things inside of a course that you can't automatically have get checked off. So some of those things involve reading. So if you've got a unit or a page that's laid out in such a way that you're asking students to read or comprehend or to think, there's no way that Sakai can magically know that they have comprehended or read or thought. But you can still provide those sorts of things over inside the checklist. So if you've added a checklist using the Add Content menus over here, you can go through and modify that checklist by using the Edit Checklist list here. The feature. So you can see that there's lots of different items here. When you look at this initially, you'll see a couple of different links that are here, and those links are what you can use to link these items to specific items on a lesson page or even on a subpage. The X obviously will remove them, and then you can use the arrows over here to resequence them. I've got a checklist title up here and some other things, but let me go through and show you how this works within the context of adding or connecting an item so that it automatically gets checked off when a student indicates in some way that they have finished that. And so when we go over here, I've got a couple things here. The reading is all going to be stuff that students have to check off manually. So they've got to actually come over here and click that they've read that particular passage or that particular bit of textbook, okay? But down here, I've got some information that involves participating in the discussion forum for these two things, and there's a quiz. These things, because of the way that they're designed inside of Sakai, allow you to go through and make them automatically check off when a student has gone through the process of doing those things. Now, there's nothing about this that's magical in the sense that it checks a student's discussion forum post for substance and depth or their assessment for correctness. It's just a matter of have they actually gone through the process of doing that thing inside the unit. And so as I go down through here, you can see that I've got those things here, and this is what's important to know. You have to set those items that you want to link to that checklist to be automatically checked off as required. You can see here I've got a little asterisk here, which in Sakai means that that particular item is required. So if I look at this discussion forum posting, the entry here that I've added, then I have the checklist here or the item here to require the student submit a posting to this topic. Okay. This is one of the other reasons why it's really good to use the Add Content menu here and add your items, such as linking to an assignment or test or quiz or forum topic or posting, because it allows you to go through and have these items interact with how the rest of the lesson pages works, as opposed to just simply using the context-sensitive menu or the entity broker to just create a link inside of a text area that goes to that discussion forum. So I've set these two things for required. I've also gone down through here and set this quiz as required. Now, I could also use some of the other prerequisite thresholds for release of items, require that the student or don't release this item until the other items are done. But in this case, I don't really care. All I care about is just showing that linking process. So because those three are actually set that way, I can go back over here to my checklist and edit the checklist such that when I come down through here, I can create a link that goes to this particular checklist item and that item on the page. Now, in some cases, it may be helpful if you're doing multiples of these to actually refer back to the page. And in some cases, it's really important to understand what you're putting here in terms of your language. If you're just saying assignment one, you may not necessarily know if that goes with an assignment, an assessment, or a discussion forum. So definitely try and keep your language consistent. In this case, I know what that goes with. I'm just going to click on the link here, and I get this modal window that lets me know these are the items that are listed on this page in this sequence from top to bottom. And so I know that one goes with the first one, and then I'll go through and link up the second one. You can see as I do this that there's a link that happens to show up, and then I get a broken link, so to the right. Essentially, what this means is I've created a link, and if I want to, I can break that link if I need to. By just simply clicking there. I'm going to go ahead and click on this one as well, and then go here and click submit, and then we'll scroll down and we'll go ahead and hit save. Now, on the surface, nothing changes in this view. So nothing changes here. If I scroll down through here, I can still, those items are still required. Nothing's changed there. If I scroll up here, it seems like nothing's changed in this checklist. But as I go over here, you'll notice there's a slight color difference between those items that I have set as required versus those that are not. And in fact, if I click over here or just hover, if I'm reading over this here, and then I pull down, I get this nice little modal pop-up that lets me know this item is linked with this item. And so these items then, as students actually finish them, will automatically check off. on this list. It's pretty handy because then we're trying to provide feedback to the student about where they are, where they left off, what they still have yet to do. The checklist function inside of Sakai is a real great tool. Hope that helps. One other thing to know is really handy is if you're using the checklist function for just seeing progress across multiple numbers of students. The great thing about also using the checklist function, especially if you're using it in a per list or a per unit or subpage, is you get a nice little sort of drop down here in when you're viewing the progress. So you can use this to jump to any of those other checklists that you might have for that particular part of your course. And so, for example, I'm already in unit 2, but if I wanted to skip back to unit 1 to see what the progress was for those students, then I could do that. And so there's a nice little navigation here. So you don't always have to use the navigation of clicking back and then going to the unit and then going through and seeing that checklist. So just a nice little other tip about how the checklist function works.